Here we are, another coffee with Coach. Thought we'd change our location up a little bit because we have Christina with us, the most famous swimmer in Upeha history. Anyways, welcome Christina to Coffee with Coach.
Thank you for having me.
We're still waiting for the coffee to show up, Andrew. Anyways, you were recruited as a swimmer. Give us a little bit about your swimming history. You came to Upeha College, you came to Upeha, your accomplishments here. Not only here, but I mean, your accomplishments in Indonesian swimming, age category, your history of swimming, it's pretty amazing.
So I actually started swimming when I was maybe in third or fourth grade. I didn't join swimming for the competitive part yet. And then I think around like middle school or something, the coach saw like a little bit of potential. That's why we started to...
What was the coach's name?
Pawanto.
Pawanto, nice job.
Yeah, in Bekasi still, in Lipo Cikarang.
Nice, Lipo Cikarang.
First time the pool was built, I already moved to another club. I think I moved to another club around high school because I wanted to take this to another level. Mm-hmm. And then we started to do more practices, like morning and then afternoon, morning before school. Yeah. So my friend knows me when I go to school, my hair will already wet mm-hmm. from training. I think it was 12th grade. I was approached by Coach Wisnu. Yeah. Coach Wisnu approached me and asked me if I want to join the swim team here. It was the first time I think you guys established the swim team and you guys are recruiting. It's kind of like, I guess Upeha also builds me to who I am right now as a swimmer. Because you guys give me the opportunity to continue my study at the same time, keep practicing and becoming a better athlete. Because I don't want to lose either swimming or education.
So the student athlete thing actually that fit your mindset anyways.
Yep. I was having like conversation as well with my parents. Like if I have to pick one, I would choose education though. Mm, but then Upeha kind of gives this opportunity to do both and not sacrificing the other. Because I enjoy both. Yeah. I do enjoy sports in general and swimming. I like the nature of the competition in swimming. It's like individual, but at the same time, it has the team atmosphere.
Yeah, because the team gets points for the overall championship.
Yes, but then it's individual sports. You compete by your own, but for your team. And it's measured, you have your goals clear, and that kind of stuff.
Because as a math major at Upeha, I mean, clear goals, measured, kind of makes sense. Let's talk a little bit about the health benefits of swimming. What benefit have you gotten by being an avid swimmer?
I think physically it's just practice swimming, practice the whole body. Yeah. Even neck and those kind of like little muscles, everything is trained. So I think it's just like the overall benefits and it burns more, really a lot of calories. It's good cardio, but then you can also have the power workout from swimming. We have like equipments like paddles when we use paddles, fins for power as well. So
to create resistance
and then it kind of just makes you heavier, makes you stronger, and then makes you swim faster. I think being a swimming athlete, I like the practice as well, how they set it up. In swimming we have sets. It's not just like one constant swim.
Nice, thank you Andrew.
When we practice, we're not just doing one long continuous swim, but we break down the practices into sets. Each sets have like a different purposes. Like we have pace workout. As an athlete, we know how to swim a certain time, how to count the stroke.
Actually, there's a lot more into it, a lot more involved than the average person would look at.
Yes.
They don't see that part.
Yes. Yeah. It's actually a very technical sport as well. Yeah. Because you're dealing with resistance. And then, you know, like when we swim, we can swim really slow, but still move faster than most people. That's only because of techniques, not really related to power.
But let's talk a little bit about slow swimming.
Okay.
Because there's a lot of people who swim, their body never changes, they never get in shape. The buoyancy of the water helps to hold them up, right?
Yes.
But that's not the way you guys swim.
No.
And if you're gonna swim and you actually put in the right amount of effort, the right amount of intensity, swimming can be a fantastic exercise.
Yes.
But if all you're going to do is just play in the water, it's better than sitting on the couch.
Yep.
But there's a lot of people who don't take advantage of what swimming can do because they simply don't want to put in the effort.
And I think that's also the tricky part about swimming and water and resistance. Even though you have the power, if you're not using it well, it actually creates more drags and you'll swim slower.
That's my problem. Yeah, I create more drag. I think that's the problem.
Then if you're not moving at all, like not putting any effort, then you're also not going anywhere. Yeah. So it's kind of like the balance between technique and power and endurance for sure. When you get the right technique, you can swim for a much longer time and then you can build the power after that. Yeah. But if you have the power, you don't have the technique, you're not gonna...
You kind of get tired of it.
Yes. When you do pull-ups, when your grip strength is already given out, even though you still have the back or shoulder, the endurance muscle, when your grip...
Yeah, when the small muscles
give out,
are done...
Yes, you're done. Yeah. You cannot really do anything.
Right. The technique is what helps the small muscle... Small muscle memory do its job in the pool.
Yes.
Yeah, see, you learned something today. Some people don't realize that you actually, because of your math proficiency, your GPA, your skills within the math department, and your skills in the pool, student athlete, you were given a scholarship and an opportunity to go and spend a semester in California.
Yes.
At Biola University. Yeah, which... Very cool. My daughter graduated from Biola. I have my master's from Biola. So when I knew you were going there, that was like, that's a great opportunity. Tell us a little bit about that experience.
It was actually a whole year.
Oh, the whole year.
Yeah. Okay. I signed up for one semester, but then the coach, and then I approached the coach. Oh, they said it's because the NAIA championship, the season is 1.5 semester long, so they cannot really accept me in the swimming team unless I can commit to the whole season. I ended up extended to 2 semesters.
Wow.
And I think it was probably the highlight of the university, to be honest. The swimming team is more established. USA has the best swimming team.
Well, for university systems, right?
Yes, and I think in Olympics they also
are the Olympics best. Were pretty good. Yes.
They also already have this system, the student-athlete. Probably people more familiar with the NCAA league championship.
NCAA, NAIA. All the regulatory players are in place. Where in Indonesia, we're moving that direction.
Moving that direction. Kind of like Lima, but more established.
Yeah, much
better
more
system.
Yeah.
They actually really proud to be a student-athlete there. And the student-athlete have really high GPA, so it's it's kind of like a normal
thing
there.
They get treated well, don't they?
Yes. Yeah. The professors really support the student athlete, but then also the coaches also respect the classes of the professors. Yeah. That's why I think things are going great there.
We're trying to do that. It's just, it's not easy. But at UPEJA, we're actually one of the few campuses that actually understands the concept. Kind of trying to create that environment. But you got to live that environment, which is pretty exciting. In our experience, individual lectures make all the difference. The faculty doesn't for some reason. But the individual lectures have a lot of influence on whether the athlete is treated fairly or treated with respect.
Yeah. Luckily for me in math department, given me the opportunity.
Nice.
But I guess it's also, I have to show them that I can...
Well, yeah, you are.
Up.
Yeah. Well, yeah, your GPA was like a 3.9 or something like that, or some ridiculous number.
It was, when I graduated, it was 3.74. I got
3.74. You dropped a little bit. And then you're considered the best swimmer in Indonesia in your age category. You competed for Indonesia international competition, correct? So you deserve some respect, honestly.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome. So what are you doing now? You've been gone now 2 years. What is your life right now?
First year after graduation, I went to China to study the language because I want to open up the opportunity, job opportunities. But then before I go back to China, I was approached by a company that I internship in before I went to China. And they offered me a job there. I've been working there for a year, a little bit more than a year. So The company itself is working in the sheet metal fabrication, but my job has nothing to do with the actual...
With metal.
With metal.
Yeah. Does it have something to do with numbers?
Actually, only a little bit.
Oh, a little bit.
It has a lot of IT element in it.
Okay. Last question for you. Discipline it took to become a champion, the discipline it took to be the swimmer at the level at which you achieved. How did swimming help you become a disciplined person? And how have you transferred that into your life No.
You need discipline everywhere in whatever you do. Probably not just swimming, but being a student athlete in general. It helps me to focus on what I'm doing at that given time. To just like be present and focus on what we're doing at that time. Like when in class, I have to focus on studying because I don't have that much time outside of class to catch up. In practice, you already give your time to swim. You just might as well do your best. Same in practice and in class. People say about student athlete needs to have really good time management, which they do. But then at the same time, I guess when you're a student athlete, your time is already, most of your time already being managed from the schedule. So you just have to make the most out of it, I guess.
Being in the moment, being fully focused on what you're doing, is if you can get into the moment, like right now, we're in this moment, and if we're fully engaged, then this is gonna be really cool. And that's what happens on the basketball court, in the swimming pool, on the soccer pool, wherever. Fully engaged in practice trains people how to be fully engaged in the classroom. And I think that is a huge importance of being a successful person.
In workplace, it's the same. You have to really be focused on your task, and then you have to designate like certain times for doing certain things, and then when you're doing that, you have to really be focused on it. Because otherwise, nothing gets done.
Yeah. If you look at the research, there's actually no such thing as multitasking. People really do much better when they train themselves to focus on one thing. Yes, you can have other things circulating in the back of your head.
Yeah.
But if you're actually trying to do three things at once, then you just do nothing very well.
Yes.
We as the human race do much better when we just go like this and go, okay, total focus on this.
I actually want to know what's behind this coffee with coach. What is the idea behind of it? How do you come up with it? And then what do you want to accomplish maybe?
This COVID-19 thing. Laura and Andrew and I were talking and thinking, what are we supposed to do? There's no students. All of our focus on our student athletes, on the students of UPEJA, on developing program and creating healthy lifestyle events and opportunities has disappeared. How can we still have influence? How can we still connect with our athletes? How can we still connect with our community? So this idea of Coffee with Coach was brought out of that. And I said, well, if we start connecting, we can still throw values, we can still have great conversation, and maybe we can connect with even more people. And if we can use our current athletes, our alumni, maybe some people from the community eventually, or lecturers and stuff that really care about what we're doing, and create a chance for us to share our message, what we believe is right and true, but do it in an Instagram-worthy way. And so we came up with that as a team. We were trying to create something that's worth doing for the good of UPEJA, for the good of our sport department, for the good of the individuals at which we get to talk to.
I'm honored then to be here and then to
well,
be
involved. We're honored to have
involved.
You. Well, thank you for being here.
Thank you so much for having me.
All right.
I guess, hope everyone's doing well during this pandemic, and then hearing from Mr. Matt about the purpose of this Coffee with Coach thing, hopefully everyone gets benefits out of it. Hopefully everyone gets maybe inspired or influenced into a better direction. So. Yeah.
Good. Okay.
Hopefully everyone's doing well.
Yep. All right. God bless. Until next time.